Apollo 13, presently 119,751 nautical miles out from Earth. Velocity now 4,734 feet per second. The scheduled television broadcast from Apollo 13 due in about 10 minutes. TV will last approximately 30 minutes and will include the activities prior to and during the mid-course correction burn number 2. 30 hours, 5 minutes ground elapsed time, and standing by, this is Apollo Control.
Okay, here it comes.
Okay.
Okay, Jack, it's coming in, and it's right in the center of our screen.
Okay, Vance,
can you, make your guess what that might be, Vance? Better than Charlie?
I don't want to start flipping coins at this point.
Okay, Vance, we're pointed. Just a little ways off from looking directly at the moon. Jim is holding the camera through window 3. The sun is coming at about 40 degrees off our left side. And what we're going to show you in just a minute is about 30 seconds of wastewater dump, and just show you just what it looks like. It's really fantastic.
Okay, we'd like to see that. We saw some droplets speeding out for a little while, Jack. Now we don't see anything.
Actually, Vance, what you're looking at is solid water droplets coming out just about all the time. It lightens up the whole sky around the moon. It's just probably too fine for you to see. Now I think they're coming out a little thicker.
Okay. Yeah, we see those.
Jack's complaining about seeing stars.
Fido says he can understand why that would perturbate a trajectory now.
It's amazing watching these frozen droplets maneuver. They seem to go in all directions, but finally they get out a certain way, settle down, and they all seem to be traveling in about the same direction.
Right, that's coming in real well.
The objects in the foreground are parts of the lamp that you're looking at. Camera's now going over to Fred.
We can just barely see those parts of the lamp. They must be.
Okay, now you're looking at a thruster plot at the lower part of your screen.
Yeah, I've got the F-stop all the way open now, man. That's quad. It's quad one you're looking at with the limb
should, or the moon should be in view just over the top of the quad.
All right, we see the nozzle of the quad, but it's dark and it's not easy to see. Houston, ENCO suggests you try average if you're in peak to see if that gives us a better picture.
Okay, we're in average now.
That helps out. We can see it better.
Okay, flight, we shouldn't leave it there too long.
Okay, now 13 requests you either move it away from the the bright area or else move it back to peak. Over.
Okay, Vance, crank the focus down a little bit. The quad coming in any better now?
It's coming in about the same, Fred. And you're a little weak now in the comp. We could see when you went back to peak. Okay, we can see you zoom in on the moon, and it's near the center of our screen, just a little to the left. Very clear.
Yeah, sure, just about at 3A.
We can't tell if it's gray or light brown, though.
Do you have your grid down there, Vince?
That's negative, Fred.
I don't know if you can make out the features there, Vance, on the moon, but looks like the Terminator's the central plains area, somewhere around Descartes, maybe.
Okay, we see it just as a bright portion of the lunar disk, and it looks a lot like you see it from Earth, very bright. We're unable to see any features at all.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same with the eyeball from here. It looks a little bigger now, but the only way I could see it very good at all was with the monocular a little while ago.
Okay, Fred, very good. We'd be interested to see in the cabin when you get ready for that, too.
Okay, I'll set up now. Down to mid-course 2, we're up to our checklist to minus 6 minutes to go.
Roger, minus 6 minutes. Understand you're about ready to turn on the gimbal motors and all that sort of thing. Okay, we see the computer now in the upper middle part of the panel. I think we see somebody's checklist in the center couch. Must be Jim holding the checklist.
Right, and what Jim's holding now, he's got a pin in his hand. We've rigged on a string as sort of a simple-minded accelerometer. This burns pretty short, and I'm not sure even that's going to show very much, but we'll see if it'll stretch out at the end of its string.
Yeah, we see the pencil at the top of the picture floating around. And Jack's coming into view now.
And I've gone back. Okay, I've gone back to average now, and that's the picture.
Roger.
in a few minutes, Vance, I guess we'll see how about the only system we hit used yet works. Everything else sure has worked mighty fine.
Right. Spacecraft's really working nicely. Okay, we're picking up panel two now. Still a little bit of a checklist. We just saw your testing of the caution and warning system at the left-hand side of the panel on our TV. See the lights all flash on. You're doing it again. Mission timer showing up as a brilliant green in the upper left-hand part of the picture.
Roger. I got the camera kind of canted on you here, Vance. Vance, Jim's going to go to box now. Vance, how do you...
Read you loud and clear, Jim.
Okay, well, what we'll do, we'll be in box for the remainder of the burn, pre-burn countdown. Why don't you go? What we're waiting for is 54 minutes on our counter, or 20, which would be minus 6.
Jim, we hear clipping on your Vox. Could you adjust it so that you're coming in continuously all the time?
Okay, stand by one. One, two, three, four, five. How's that, Ben?
Okay, that's better.
How do you read the CMP on Vox?
Jack, read you loud and clear.
Okay, fine. We're showing minus 8.5 minutes.
Roger, Houston copies.
Is that too close, Vance, or can you make out the SPS engine panel now?
We can see your fuel and oxidizer gauges and hydrogen and oxygen gauges at the top of the picture and the pugs, but it isn't coming in focus too well. It's a little dim.
Yeah, I think the problem is I'm about at 2 feet and it doesn't go down but to 4.
Right, we understand that's the panel right in front of your face.
Okay, just stand by for the main dual motor.
Okay, we're minus 7 minutes.
Roger. The focus is good enough that we can see the position of your 4 ball valves at the top of the picture for the big SBS engine.
Oh, which one to watch, Vance?
Hopefully, you'll see the, or we'll see the two on the left here, set A, go on here directly.
Minus 6 minutes. They both eyes two on the SBS helium valve 2 auto and check auto power pole. ABC servo power is 1 AC 1 main A, 2 AC 2 main B.
AC 1 main A, AC 2 main B. Main bus times on.
Okay, rotational power normal, number 2 AC.
For 2 AC.
Direct 2 off.
Direct 2 off.
B mags, 3 at 1 rate 2.
At 1 rate 2.
Spacecraft control SCS.
BS.
And I'm your hand controller.
Right, C armed.
Okay, let's do a primary TVC check.
Ready, you ready to start primers?
Okay, go ahead, primers.
Okay, pitch 1, start.
Good.
Yaw 1, start.
That one's good.
Thumb wheel control. 0.96 plus 0.96 minus 0.23.
That's firm. Check up TVC.
TVC check. Okay.
Okay.
CMC.
See?
Trim returns to neutral.
Likewise on the translation controller.
Why? No MTVC.
No MTVC, okay.
Starting to sprint.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Pitch 2, start.
Good.
Yaw 2, start.
Okay.
Oh, good.
Good. Good trim control. Minus 0.96. Plus 0.96, minus 0.23.
Good.
MTVC. Mission control neutral. Back to trim
okay.
To 0.
No MTVC.
No MTVC.
Okay.
B max mode rate 2.
Station line control power 2 normal AC DC.
DC DC.
Direct 2 main A main B.
B.
Okay, B max you got 3 rate 2. Okay, we'll proceed for final trim.
Mike's where we are.
Okay, B-Bag mode 3 at 1 rate 2.
At 1 rate 2.
Hamble enter. Okay, we'll do the gimbal test off.
Okay, proceed.
Proceed.
Plus 2. Minus 2. 0. Plus 2. 2. 0.
And we can hear and feel the engine gimbal as we do the test.
Okay.
FDI
scale.
Set in and trim
a
set.
FDI scale
5-5. 5-5.
Brake high, I'm updating the DET.
Time?
Let's check it.
Okay, we're coming up on 3 minutes, I'll give you a mark.
All right on.
Mark, 3 minutes. DET is good.
Okay, we're set. At 58, we want double V thrust A to normal.
Jim Houston, you're looking good down here. Go for the burn.
Right,
might be interested in how we find out how far we're away from the moon. going to do that right now in program 21 here.
Okay.
I'm asking the computer how far away we are. And the computer is telling me we're 121,490 miles out.
Okay, that agrees fairly closely with our map on the wall.
I'm glad. That means you're tracking us too.
And if you didn't see our residuals, it was 1/10x, 2/10 of the Y, and 1/10 of Z, and the delta VC was -3.8.
Jack Houston, we show you down here 121,000 miles, 520 out. So I guess we all agree.
Okay, real good, Vance. What I'm going to do is give you a shot of Fred. We can get all the wiring out of the way. The only problem here is when you move the TV around, this wire follows you like a snake here.
Yeah, we have Fred now. Looks like he has a lariat there, getting ready to rope the checklist.
That's only half of it. We have most of it hidden away. It's been pretty interesting doing all the camera work here to get a little extra training running the TV here, hopefully for when we get on the ground for tomorrow. The monitor does make it pretty easy, though.
All right. That's a real advantage in the cockpit. You're just a little bit dark. Looks like it might help to have the f-stop run down about one increment. See how it
can't
comes
do it.
Out.
We're wide open.
Are you?
I think we're wide open now.
Yeah, we're wide open, Vance. Okay, does that help any, Vance?
Okay, it's reasonably good. We can make out Fred fairly well. Looks like he's in a shadow. Hey, that helps. You just turned up the lights, huh?
Yeah, we went fixed on the...
Okay, you're on candid camera.
We did notice one thing, Vance. You know that dude fat with long hair? Won't work too well up here in space.
What was that one again?
They say you know the dude fat with long hair?
Right.
It doesn't work too well up in space. You can't comb your hair up here.
Well, I guess you have to give up something. Well, at least it helps to try. We can see you trying to comb your hair there, Jim. Looks like your beards haven't come along to the point where you've had to use the razor, though.
Well, we've been debating that. We thought we'd take care of our beards tomorrow and make that one of our daily routines. Take it that was a subtle hint, man.
No, we're not commenting on your appearance, Fred. I mean, nothing derogatory, understand.
And, Vance, I thought we'd get a picture of Jack just so that all the girls know that he's still here. Say hello, Vance.
Yeah, we appreciate that. There he is. Big Jack. Jack, you're in the shadow right now. We have a little bit of interference from your window, which is very bright. So we We can't, I think you're smiling, but it's a little hard to tell. Hey, there we go. Incidentally, we've been getting all kinds of bits of information to pass up to you. We've had baseball scores coming in, basketball. Somebody said there are 220 days, shopping days left till Christmas. It was a tie between Littler and Casper after 72 holes, and there's going to be a playoff Monday, we understand.
Oh, sounds good.
Be interested in knowing is what you do after the burn in the way of configuring switches back. We heard you go through the checklist, but I guess right now, basically, you probably have all the switches back in position and you're in the mode to continue on with what does the flight plan say? You're going to be doing cislunar navigation. So, Jack, you'll be down in the LEB, is that correct?
That's right, Vance, and I'll be going down there shortly.
Okay, the TV now is all but black. Looks like it must be pointing into a shadow.
What he's doing there, he's trying to give you one more shot of the moon, and right now I'm setting up the maneuver to the optics calibration attitude.
Roger.
Yeah, what I'd wanted to point out, I don't know if it's apparent, but to show the advantage of doing all the dumps just before the burn, we're looking again at the same scene over quad one at the moon, and now you don't see all the sparkly frozen particles outside there anymore. We've sort of run off and left them.
Roger. We don't see anything out there anymore in the way of particles leaving the spacecraft. We'd suggest maybe you zoom the moon in a little bit again so we can see the shape of it better. Brings the moon in. We can see the terminator at the top of the melon-shaped disk.
Okay, and now you can see a few sparkling particles going across the screen. Those are being emitted from the thrusters. Jack's maneuvering the spacecraft now.
Okay, we can see those very poorly. Actually, they're coming in better now. It looks like little specks going from the upper left part of the screen across to the right. And understand those are from the thrusters.
That's firm.
13 Houston, just as an item of interest, advise your speed with respect to the Earth now is 4,667 feet per second.
Okay, thanks, man.
Apollo 13 Houston, the moon has been in and out of our screen here. Right now it's off the bottom side, but we can still see the particles coming off from the spacecraft.
Okay, I'm going to have to pull it out of the window now, Vance. The sun's coming up on the right side.
Roger, understand you.
Do you want to see the sun down the LED, Vance?
Say again. See what you're doing down in the LED or the far corner of the spacecraft where the optics are. Might be interesting to describe what you will do in the next few minutes in the way of sighting.
Okay, Vance, first we're going to give you a shot of sleep station.
Jack's getting the sleep station rolled up. I thought I'd show you one in the corner. We've got our temporary stowage back here, and that's where all our waste paper and all that goes while we're after every meal. It's in the right-hand corner down by our dump system.
Roger, I understand we're looking at the waste basket.
And the age-old question that's always asked us is how do we get rid of liquid waste? And that line that you see, I think you can see it now, it goes right outside where we open up the overboard drain dump, and all our waste products, liquid waste products, go out through that line and get dumped overboard.
Roger, understand, and we can see somebody's foot as well.
Okay, Fred's now going down there, and he's going to try to get underneath the sleep station on his side, where we have a sleep restraint, and the whole object of that is to position the body between the bottom on his side, where we have a sleep restraint, and the whole object of that is to position the body between the bottom of the spacecraft, and so it doesn't float up between that and the bottom of the couch.
Roger, the sleep restraint or the hammock's coming into view underneath the couch. It's a white object.
You perhaps can see the zipper of the hammock right now. It's the black line in that white object.
Right, we can see it.
These hammocks, by the way, are very comfortable. When we first heard about them in the design of Apollo, we thought they weren't necessary, but they turned out to be very nice devices to sleep in. right now to get down there with Fred to show you how it works. I keep floating up though, but maybe we can get a little shot here.
Okay, we have somebody upside down in the photograph there now. Realizing, of course, in space, there is no really right side up or upside down. It still looks that way to us.
Okay, that's Fred now. I'm trying to put him right side up for you folks back there in the space station. Fred, would you move your hands there so the folks back home can see you?
Okay, that's coming in real clear, Jim. We see Fred in the sleeper restraint.
As a matter of fact, Vance, I find Fred down there all the time.
Yeah, I can see he appreciates that. Looks fairly comfortable. Looks like there's a lot of room down there, considering all the boxes on the floor underneath the couch.
It's surprising. There still is quite a bit of room down there, even with the HiCon camera box down. And right now, I'm going to bring the camera back up. No more than what you see right now. We'll terminate our little TV for you today.
Okay, thank you very much, Jim. Appreciate it seeing you.
See you, thanks, bye. Thank you.